Hey guys, how's it going? So today we're going to be doing a camera comparison between my new iPhone XS Max and my old iPhone 7 Plus. Like I mentioned in my first impressions video, I don't take a lot of photos with my phones anymore because as a part-time photographer and an enthusiast, I always prefer to use my big dedicated camera rather than using my cell phone to capture the moments because I have so much more control with it. I can change the settings, I can change the lenses. So at least for me, traveling with a backpack full of lenses and camera gears is worth it because what I'm interested in is capturing the moment in the best way possible, not in the most convenient way possible. So when I first bought this phone, the camera was the last thing I was worried about. I mainly upgraded because of the bigger screen and it's faster, it's better in every way. And as it happens every year, I knew they would improve the camera somewhat and I knew it was going to be better, but I didn't know how much it was going to be better. I was honestly very, very surprised with the camera. And the biggest upgrade this year with this phone or the camera is the Smart HDR. HDR is an acronym for high dynamic range, or also known as bracketing. And what it is when you take a photo of a high contrast subject, for example, like an extremely bright sky and also a shadowy area under a tree. So what you do is you take several photos, some overexposed to expose the shadowy area properly, and also underexposed photos to expose the sky properly, and you basically merge those photos together to create the illusion of HDR, high dynamic range. Most cameras on the market can do that, and also you can take the photos yourself and then merge them together either in Photoshop or any other softwares. But the problem is, because you're taking several photos, if something moves or if your camera moves, when you merge those photos together, it's going to come out blurry because there's motion. What the new iPhone's camera does with Smart HDR is that it can take those several photos in different exposures simultaneously. So even after merging all those photos together, your photos come out sharp without any blurriness and everything is exposed properly. I know this may sound a bit boring to some of you, but this is a big deal. So I could go on, but let's take a look at some of the examples. Oh, and one more thing. I told you in my first impressions video that I'm going to be doing a comparison between my iPhone 7 Plus and the XS Max and my DSLR. But on this video, I'm going to be focusing only on the iPhone XS Max and the 7 Plus because those two are much similar cameras. And after testing the XS Max, I realized that it's much more complicated than simply just choosing which photo looks best. So the comparison between my XS Max and my DSLR will be coming soon, so stay tuned for that. So in this first example, you can see the difference pretty much right away. And you can see the darker areas are much better exposed in the XS Max's example. And on the 7 Plus, the sky where the clouds are seems a bit overexposed. And you can also see the light flare coming in. And on the XS Max, that is much more reduced. And that's probably because of the new coating on their new lens elements. And you can still see some of the artifacts of the flare here and there, but it's really not as noticeable as on the 7 Plus. On the next example, the difference is not as instantly noticeable, but if you zoom in, you can see that the grains and the leaves are much more prominent and sharper. And since both phones use 12 megapixel sensors, this could be achieved by either using a sharper lens or by digital sharpening after taking the photo. But either way, I think it's a much better image. So as you can see, when there's good lighting and when it's sunny outside, the differences aren't that dramatic apart from the sharpness. But as you'll be able to see in some of the other examples, the differences become much more prominent when you're shooting in less than ideal lighting situation, like when you're shooting directly into the sun or when you're shooting in low light. On the next photo, the light flare on the iPhone 7 Plus is back, and on the XS Max, that's much better managed, and you can still see some of the artifacts, but it's really not as bad. What I wanted to show you on this photo is the shadowy areas on my car. As you can see, or as you cannot see, a lot of the details were lost in the 7 Plus's example, whereas on the XS Max's photo, you can still see the details in the shadowy areas much better. Okay, now let's take a look at some landscapes. The next photo I'm going to show you one at a time because it almost nearly blew my mind. And here's the example from the iPhone 7 Plus. As you can see, the lens flares back, and although it's a beautiful scenery, the contrast not that great, the color's not that great. Although you could probably make this somewhat decent for Instagram maybe, it's not really a great photo, especially if you look at these areas where the trees are. They look like they were painted almost. There's not a lot of detail there or anywhere else, to be honest. And now let's take a look at the picture, same picture from the iPhone XS Plus. And here it is. look at the difference. Look at the trees, look at the color, and the lens flare is gone. I mean, there's so much more detail and the color is much more pleasing to look at. It's still not perfect, but it's million miles apart. I mean, now that I look at it, I'm not just amazed by how great the photo from the XS Max is, I'm also amazed by how terrible the 7 Plus's photo is. Like, I mean, no wonder why I stopped shooting photos with my smartphones, right? I mean, it just makes me think, was it always this bad? Anyway, like I mentioned before, when you're taking a JPEG photo with a modern camera, especially your smartphones, there's a lot of processing happening inside the camera, even before you get to see the photo that you just took. Things like color correction, noise reduction, sharpening, softening. But these examples, apart from the color maybe, there's no way you can make this photo look like this photo just with some Photoshop. Like, it's a completely different photo. That tells me that the new lenses and the sensors in the new iPhone XS and the XS Max are just that much better than the ones in the 7 Plus. Next, let's take a look at some of the portrait mode examples. And in the portrait mode, to be honest, it wasn't all that much better. I think this had much more to do with the software update in iOS 12, not the cameras themselves. Because between the examples from my 7 Plus and the XS Max, I honestly can't tell the difference. And the XS Max still made plenty of mistakes where it wasn't masking the areas that it should have. But the biggest difference is that now you can adjust the background blur after you take the photo. There were only very few times where bumping up the aperture to 1.4 actually made the photo better. Actually, just keeping it at the default setting made the photos look much more natural. So personally, I wouldn't worry too much about this, but the portrait mode on the iPhones are still the best in the industry, so I think that's a good thing. Now it's time to talk about the beauty gate. So if you haven't heard about it by now, a lot of people are talking about the new selfie cameras on the new iPhones over-softening their faces. And if I didn't hear about it, I would have never noticed it because I never take selfies. So based on my photos, the softening is definitely there, but it's really not as noticeable as I thought it would be. Also, it might be because I have perfectly smooth skin. So I guess the results might vary depending on your skin conditions and how much facial hair you have, but to me, it didn't make a whole lot of difference.
Now let's take a look at some videos. So here I'm just walking with the iPhone 7 Plus on my left hand and my iPhone XS Max on my right hand. No gimbals or any tripods or anything like that. And with the videos, I'm mainly looking at three things. The stabilization, audio, and obviously the image quality. I'm recording at 4K 30 frames per second because the 7 Plus only goes up to 30 while the XS Max goes up to 60. So the first thing that I noticed is that although these are both stabilized, it seems like the footage from the XS Max is much more stable. It's not perfect, but there's a lot less jerkiness as I'm walking around. If I'm a little more careful, it looks like it could be used as a vlogging camera without a gimbal, which is very impressive. And if I just pause the videos here, it looks like the 4K from the iPhone XS Max is slightly sharper, and also the color seems more contrasty. So overall, the footage from the iPhone XS Max looks better. And now I'm going to alternate the audio from both footages so you can listen to them and see what you think. And next, I'm testing the video with the portrait lens. And as you may know, the portrait lens on the iPhone XS Max is stabilized, whereas the iPhone 7 Plus's portrait lens is not. And you can probably see the difference here.
So that's it for today, guys. Thank you for watching and hope this is helpful. So next time I'm going to be doing a comparison between my iPhone XS Max and my 60 Mark II, my DSLR that I use to film my YouTube videos. And like I said, it's not going to be just about comparing images and deciding which one looks better, but it's also more about the capabilities of what modern DSLRs can do and what modern smartphone cameras can do. So please stay tuned for that and I will see you next time. Bye bye.